Hi, my name's Rebecca Carey, and I'm a volcanologist. I love volcanoes because they are in spectacular landscapes all across the Earth. I teach a range of different earth sciences, inclusive of volcanology. I've been at the University of Tasmania for about 9 years now, and today we're going to talk about the explosivity associated with the volcanism on Hawaii. And just last week I was promoted to Associate Professor. My childhood was one where we moved around every year or every 2 years. When I was 8 years old, I lived in outback Queensland, and I really loved to spend my weekends collecting rocks and minerals, and that really gave me a sense of discovery. I've seen a number of volcanic eruptions from really close quarters, and the experience is just mesmerising. It can be very loud, it can be very hot, it can be a very toxic environment. In some circumstances, we can actually go up with our geological hammers and touch the lava on the surface. I studied volcanology at the University of Hawaii. At the time, I didn't have any money as an undergraduate student, so I worked for a volcanology professor. And so I helped him with field trips to go to the active volcano of Kilauea, and I was able to see magma being erupted at the Earth's surface 3 or 4 times during that year, and that's what gave me my love for volcanology and volcanoes. However, a submarine volcano north of the North Island of New Zealand erupted in 2012. A passenger flying from Tonga to Auckland saw remnants of this gigantic pumice raft on the ocean surface. In 2015, 3 years after the eruption, we took 2 robots on a ship 1,000 kilometres north of Auckland to understand exactly what had happened at Havre Volcano in 2012. What we concluded was that that eruption had erupted about 1,000 times the MCG in terms of volcanic rocks. We discovered the largest submarine eruption in the last 3 centuries. Pumice rock was dispersed across the Pacific Ocean to Australia and even Tasmania. The Australian Academy of Science Dorothy Hill Medal is awarded annually to the top female earth and marine scientist. To be the awardee in 2020 is an amazing honour, and it's very special for me because it reflects also on the teams that I've worked with that have really contributed that science. The best thing about being a volcanologist is getting boots on the ground and going into these amazingly spectacular volcanic landscapes to understand how they formed.